I'm now delighted to say that sat a matter of feet opposite me are two of the funniest men to come out of England for the last 20 years, but only one of them means it. It's Ricky Gervais and Karl Pilkington.
Ricky and Karl, how are you both today?
Very well, thank you.
Good.
Don't be fooled by the body language. Inside, he's doing backflips. It's like a party going on up there.
Now, you are back on our screens with the Ricky Gervais Show. Karl, the show seems to revolve around Ricky and Steve just endlessly berating you. Do you have any self-esteem left now that it's season three?
It's nothing new, this.
Really?
Because when it wasn't Ricky and Steve, yeah, it was sort of school, teachers, me mum and dad. And I sort of know what I mean anyway. When I'm saying stuff, I know that I'm not that great,
yeah,
at explaining what I'm getting at. But deep down, there's something there.
Yeah, there is. He doesn't look smart. And he didn't have a formal education, but he's got a spark of genius about him.
Yeah. I'm like Columbo. Do you know, like, everyone goes, he's daft.
Yeah.
And then he gets them in the end.
Actually,
we haven't got to the end yet. But I'm going to get them in the end.
Yeah. Well, let's have a little look. This is the Ricky Gervais Show.
Who'd have thought the Frisbee would have caught on?
I love the fact that you think the Frisbee is the pinnacle of invention.
Yeah.
I think it's amazing.
No, it's an example of something that, you know, if he was on some programme where, you know, you said, I've invented this, did go, get out. They wouldn't give him time of day to say, right, I've made this thing, it's out of plastic, you throw it about. What for? Well, you just chuck it about on the beach. What's the point? It's a bit of fun, isn't it? No, I don't like it.
An argument with himself.
Karl, you're kind of like a good moan. Is there anything today that has annoyed you today? Anything you want to get off your chest?
You didn't want to do this, did you, for a start?
This has been a bit of a moan just now. The stuff that I've got to do when I'm here.
Yeah.
hang on, what's been going on today?
Any news?
I sort of look at the news to cheer me up.
Do you?
Yeah. There's a bloke who's got a problem with, can you say testicles on T4?
Yeah, right?
You can say the scientific word for it.
Yeah, he's got a massive pair. 7 stone.
What?
7 stone. They're just there. It's sort of,
yeah. But does he walk around with them?
Kind of.
And they got like a little hammock or something, or a sling.
Well, still, they're massive, so he's sort of walking and...
So they are big, they're not just dense.
No, it's like a big...
Yeah. It's just, can't he just carry it? Can't he have a little trolley or something? Why not? Have it like a little hostess trolley. So he'd have it, little wheels like that, a little thing. The testicles will go on the table, he'd just push them around, and they'd be resting. When he wasn't... They're not hanging, so it's no stretching. That must be pulling him. That must be terrible. 7 stone. Mm. That's like having Warwick hanging from your bits.
So we thought we'd finish things off with a little quiz. Karl, I understand that you've got some rockbusters for us. What's a rockbuster?
It's like a music quiz. I give you some cryptic clues. Mm.
They're not cryptic.
As to an artist's name, and I give you some initials of that artist.
Have you seen Blockbusters? It's that, but he changed the name. Okay.
Got it.
Here we go.
Got it. Okay,
right.
I'm ready for the...
Okay,
go for
the
it.
First one.
Give us three.
That's a laptop, and the initial is... A.
That's quite a good one, actually. That one works. I'm disappointed.
She's looking at your answers.
Oh,
yeah.
You've got the first letter.
Did we get a point for that?
I think you've had enough time on that one. Second question.
Look how round that head is.
The Spanish person is celebrating about the present he got for Jesus. The initials there, O-M.
This is Spanish people. This is... You've got better at these.
Have you got it?
Yeah.
I haven't got it.
Think about it. They're cryptic. Just think about what I'm saying. Listen to the question.
Yeah, no, I am, yeah.
The Spanish people are celebrating. Spanish. What do Spanish people do when they celebrate? What do they say?
Well...
And they've got a gift for Jesus.
Yeah. Okay.
Question three.
Right. You can actually see the brain kick in. You know, like when you pull a thing on a boat?
Yeah, yeah.
He does that, he has to go... right, and then he has to... Yeah, yeah. Right.
The Asian person's leg... is a little bit angry. TT is the initials.
My God. I've got it.
I've got none of them.
Well, this is really worrying.
Please, could we have the answers, Karl?
For the first one.
The answer?
Adele.
Adele.
Oh,
nice. Okay. Yeah.
The Spanish people celebrate the present they got for Jesus.
Ole Mer, Ole Mers.
Correct. Yes.
I copied Georgie, yes, so I'm not giving myself one, but I got the last one.
The last one, the Asian woman's leg is a bit angry.
Yeah.
TT.
Tiny temper.
Tie, knee, temper.
Very good.
Well done.
Guys, listen, well done to everybody that was involved in that incredible experience. It's been brilliant having you here. You're back, because at 12:40, you're going to be featuring on our brand new chat show, Angry Chat. For now, Ricky Gervais and Karl Pilkington, everybody.
Oh, you can't clap. I was clapping that, so.
Today.
Any news?
I sort of look at the news to cheer me up.
Do you?
Yeah, yeah. There's a bloke who's got a problem with, can you say testicles on T4?
Yeah, yeah,
I think you can say the scientific word for anything.
Yeah, he's got a massive pair. 7 stone.
What?
7 stone. They're just there, sort of.
Yeah. But does he walk around with them?
Kind of.
And they got like a little hammock or something, or a sling?
Well, still, they're massive, so he's sort of walking and...
So they are big, they're not just dense.
No, it's like a big...
Yeah. It's just, can't he just carry it? Can't he have a little trolley or something? Why not? Have it like a little hostess trolley, so he'd have it like little wheels like that, a little thing. The testicles will go on the table. He'd just push them around, and they'd be resting. When he wasn't, they're not hanging, so it's no stretching. That must be pulling him. That must be terrible. 7 stone. Mm. That's like having Warwick hanging from your bits.
So we thought we'd finish things off with a little quiz. Karl, I understand that you've got some rockbusters for us. What's a rockbuster?
It's like a music quiz. I give you some cryptic clues as to an artist's name, and I give you some initials of that artist.
Have you seen Blockbusters? It's that, but he changed the name. Okay.
Got it. Right. Okay,
here we go.
Got it. Okay,
right.
I'm ready for the first one.
Give us three.
That's a laptop, and the initial is A.
That's quite a good one, actually. That one works. I'm disappointed.
Oh,
she's looking
no
at your answers.
Oh,
yes, yeah.
You've got the first letter.
I've got the first letter.
Can we get a point for that?
I think you've had enough time on that one. Second question.
Look how round that head is.
The Spanish person is celebrating about the present he got for Jesus. The initials there, O-M.
This
the
is
Spanish
good.
People.
This is, you've got better at these.
Have you got it?
Yeah.
I haven't got it.
Think about it, they're cryptic. Just think about what I'm saying. Listen to the question.
You know
what
I am, yeah.
The Spanish people are celebrating. Right. What do Spanish people do when they celebrate? What do they say?
Well,
and they've got a gift for Jesus.
Yeah. Okay.
Question 3.
Right. You can actually see the brain kick in. You know, like when you pull a thing on a boat?
Yeah, yeah.
He does that, he has to go, right, and then he has to, right.
The Asian person's leg is a little bit angry. TT is the initials.
My God. I've got it.
No, all three. I've got none of them.
Well, this is really worrying.
Please, could we have the answers, Karl?
For the first one.
The answer?
Adele.
Adele.
Oh,
nice. Okay. Yeah.
The Spanish people celebrate presently.
A spark of genius about him.
Yeah. I'm like Columbo. Do you know, like, everyone goes, he's daft.
Yeah.
And then he gets them in the end.
Actually.
We haven't got to the end yet. But I'm gonna get them in the end.
Yeah. Well, let's have a little look. This is the Ricky Gervais Show.
Who'd have thought the frisbee would have caught on?
I love the fact that you think the frisbee is the pinnacle of invention.
Yeah,
I think it's amazing.
No, it's an example of something that, you know, if he was on some program where you know, you said I've invented this, did go get out. They wouldn't give him time of day to say right, I've made this thing. It's out of plastic. You throw it about. What for? Well, he just chuck it about on the beach. What's the point? It's a bit of fun, isn't it? No, I don't like it.
How many? Okay, that was an argument with himself.
Karl, you kind of like a good moan. Is there anything today that has annoyed you today? Anything you want to get off your chest?
You didn't want to do this, did you, for a start?
this is a bit of a moan just now. The stuff that I've got to do when I'm here.
Yeah.
hang on, what's been going on?
I'm now delighted to say that sat a matter of feet opposite me are two of the funniest men to come out of England for the last 20 years, but only one of them means it. It's Ricky Gervais and Karl Pilkington.
Ricky and Karl, how are you both today?
Very well, thank you.
Good.
Don't be fooled by the body language. Inside, he's doing backflips. It's like a party going on up there.
Now, you are back on our screens with the Ricky Gervais Show. Karl, the show seems to revolve around Ricky and Steve just endlessly berating you. Do you have any self-esteem left now that it's season three?
It's nothing new, this.
Really?
Because when it wasn't Ricky and Steve, it was sort of school, teachers, me mum and dad. And I sort of know what I mean anyway. When I'm saying stuff, I know that I'm not that great at explaining what I'm getting at. But deep down, there's something there.
Yeah, there is. He doesn't look smart, and he didn't have a formal education, but he's got a